BGMC. The biblical truth lives here.
Psalm 33, verses 1, 2, and 3, it says, "Rejoice in Jehovah, you righteous, praise is well suited to the upright. Give thanks to Jehovah with the lyre, sing praises to him with the 10-string harp. Sing to him a new song, make music at your best, among shouts of joy." Amen? So let us all say, Shalom. Say shalom to someone you don't know. Shalom to someone.
I know you.
All right, we're going to sing about delighting in Shabbat. How many people delight in Shabbat?
Amen.
Avinu Malkeinu, our Father, our King, Lowly delight. Your rest and your praises we sing. Lord, we delight in your Shabbat. We delight in your
Shabbat, but what is it? It's a celebration of everything that he has done. And it's really impossible in four songs to do that, but we're going to try to cover everything. We're celebrating because everything, all those little birds, all those little flowers, I mean, if you've ever looked around, every single one of them is a miracle.
Amen.
And the greatest miracle, of course, is Yeshua's deliverance from sin, which we can't do on our own and never could. So we recognize that he is able when we are not. And what a relief that is. Those of you who, like myself, before I got saved, thought I had to do it all on my own. And it was a disaster. So, even when you're hurting, he is able. We have a lot to celebrate, and sometimes it's hard to celebrate. But he says, do it anyway. Have joy in everything. So let's cry out his name to the God that is able.
Come on.
You're going to face Yerushalayim. Wherever you are in the world, put your panim and face it towards Jehovah's holy city. And we're going to do the Shema. Shema Israel, Yehovah Eloheinu, Yehovah Echad, Baruch Shem. Sar Shalom back to his house, back to that land. That you would open up the hearts of those people, that they would turn towards you in teshuvah, and you would make everything all right. Open up the hearts of both Jew and Gentile, Jew and Arab alike, that they would bend the knee to the Sar Shalom, the Prince of Peace, and they would come to know him and call him Savior. In Yeshua's name I pray.
Some of the most powerful prayers in the scriptures only have a few lines. They reach everybody's heart because it came from the Spirit through a man maybe 1,000 years ago, 2,000 years ago, 3,000 years ago. Our God never changes. And so from Exodus 15, the prayer came from the lips of the prophet Micha Mocha. Elim Adonai, who is like you, O Lord, among the gods. After everything that Moshe had seen and heard, this was about the only thing that he could think of to say. There's just nobody like him. He does wonders before our eyes. Thank you. face to face with your King, the love of your soul, Yeshua, your Redeemer. And there he is on his throne, crowned in glory. And when you're done trembling, you try to think of something to say. And the only thing that you can do is utter his name. You catch your breath. And there he is in front of you, and you say the precious name.
Speak the name that has no fear. Speak the name that draws us near. Speak the name to be revered and treasured. Speak the name that saves us all. Speak the name that makes you whole. Speak the name that holds the world together. Yeshua, no other. And he is the Lord of the Shabbat.